Good morning, kids. We are back for a new week of New Creation Church Kids Church. I'm super excited to be with you this morning. Let's jump right into our lesson. Last week, remember we talked about obedience and how important it was to follow your parents' instruction and also God's instruction, because we don't want God to be disappointed in our decisions. I know that it can be hard to make the right choice. I do understand. But I also want you to know that if you need wisdom, if you need help with making decisions, remember our memory verse from last week. Remember James 1:5. If you need wisdom, ask God for it. If you're having a time trying to figure out what decision you should make, is it a good choice or a bad choice? You can always ask God for wisdom. You can pray to him and he will guide you and lead you. If you need help making decisions, you can also talk to your parents. They will also help you and give you direction and help you to make good, smart decisions. All right? All right, so last week we talked about Adam and Eve and how they didn't quite make the right decision and God was not pleased with their decision. They were embarrassed, they were scared, and they hid from God. Let's watch that video again so you guys can get a recap of what happened last week.
The first man and woman, Adam and Eve, lived in a beautiful garden that God made for them. But Satan came as a crafty serpent and tempted Adam and Eve.
"Did God say you must not eat the fruit from these trees?" the serpent asked Eve.
"Just the tree in the middle," Eve replied. "If we eat from it, we'll die."
"You won't die," said the serpent. "There's a reason why God doesn't want you to eat from that tree. If you do, you'll be like him. You'll know what he knows."
Eve ate the fruit. She gave some to Adam, who was with her. He ate it too. And at once, they knew things they had never known before. One thing they knew was that they were naked. They sewed leaves together to cover themselves. They'd never felt fear or shame before, so they knew something was wrong. "Adam," God called. "Eve."
"We're hiding," said Adam. "We're naked."
"You know that because you ate from the tree," God sighed.
Then Adam blamed Eve, and Eve blamed the serpent.
God said, "Serpent, you must crawl on your belly. A woman's son will defeat you."
"Eve, childbirth will be painful. Adam, growing food will be difficult."
Then God made clothes for Adam and Eve and sent them out of the garden. He put an angel with a flaming sword there so they could not return.
Okay, so you guys remember that video. Adam and Eve were in the garden. God said, "Don't eat from the fruit from this tree, this one tree. You can eat from any other tree in the garden except this one." But remember that serpent came and the serpent tricked them, and Eve ate from the fruit and she shared it with Adam, and God was not pleased. It can be hard, I know. Friends are around, they may be telling you to do one thing, and you're trying to figure out how to make the right decision, how to please God. I know it can be hard. But remember, our memory verse states, if you need wisdom, ask God for it. Always remember that. There's always a good choice and the wrong choice. Let's play a quick little game, okay? I want to help you guys to think about making good choices. So I'm going to give you two options, all right? Two options, and you have to pick which is the good choice and which is the not so good choice, okay? All right, you ready? Here's our first option. Should we smile big when we meet a new friend, or should we make a mean face? What do you guys think we should do? Should we smile big or make a mean face? We should smile big. We should smile big and say, "Good morning, how are you? It's nice to meet you." We extend our hand, we shake our hand, tell them your name and ask for their name, all right? Here's our second one. What's the right choice and what's the wrong choice? Should we tell our friends, "You're not nice," or should we say, "I love you"? Which one should we do? Say, "You're not nice," or say, "I love you"? You're right. If you said, "Say I love you," you are right. We should always show kindness and love to our friends and our family and our those in need. All right, let's do one more. Ready? All right. If we see someone, should we help them get up or should we laugh at them? What do you guys think? If you see someone that's fallen down, should you help them get up or should you laugh at them? If you said help them get up, you made the right choice. Good job. You are on your way to making great decisions. Give yourself a round of applause. Good job. I love that you guys are making good decisions. You're already off to a great start. I think it is time for a little worship song and dance. Let's get ready to dance. This is a new song this week. It's called My Whole Self. Let's take a listen.
So I can listen. You made my eyes.
One, two.
So I can see. You made my arms.
One, two.
So I can praise you. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak. Every thought I think. Everything I do. My whole self belongs to you. You made my hands.
One, two.
For helping others. You made my feet.
One, two.
So I can follow you. You made my legs.
One, two.
To jump for Jesus. You made my heart. So I can love. Every word I speak.
That was a fun and exciting song, right? Did you guys enjoy that? Everything I do, my whole self belongs to you. We're finishing up our topic talking about good choices. I want to share with you this week's activity. Parents, you should have received this download. If you don't have it, you can send us an email, you can send us a message on Facebook Messenger, or you can send us a message and remind, and we'll make sure to get this right out to you. This week, we are making an obedience tree. And I want to share with you the tree that Josiah created. So, what we have here is an apple tree. And you're going to cut out all of the apples that show good choices that you make. And I'll read to you what some of the good choices Josiah has. He says, I listen to my parents and do as I'm told. He says, I listen to my teacher and complete all of my assignments. He also says, when mommy and daddy call me, I come right away. Good job, Josiah, for making good choices. I am excited to see your trees. I can't wait to see what you put on them and what your apple tree looks like. Parents, let's continue our discussion this week with our kids. Let's talk to them about making good choices, about how to make good choices. I want you to say this with me. Kids, you ready? I'll say it. Repeat after me. This week, I will make good choices. Are you ready? Let's say it together. This week, I will make good choices. And I know you can because you are wonderful, you are awesome, and you are a child of God. And Mommy and Daddy are going to be so proud. They're going to reward you and thank you and be so appreciative that you are using your good listening ears and doing exactly as you're told. Before we leave, let's have some prayer time. Are you ready? Let's get in our prayer posture. Hands together, head bowed, and eyes closed. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for our friends and our family. We thank you that you continue to teach us about being obedient. We thank you that you help us to make good choices. Even when those around us may be making bad choices, you always lead us and guide us in the right direction. And for that, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You guys, we have just finished another week of Kids Church. Are you excited? I'm so excited about teaching you guys and all the lessons that we've got in store for you. This is amazing, and you are amazing because God made you that way. We come back next week, right here, same time, same place. We will learn another wonderful lesson about God and His creations. Bye.